Hello there. It's John from Juggernaut Performance. This is another Tech Talk short that we're going to do. Tonight we're going to talk a little bit about our fuel systems. Now, it is winter time here in New England and kind of off season for a lot of people that are racing. A lot of people are inquiring about over the winter upgrades. You've got your Boost, people that bought stuff on Black Friday. So, we are getting a lot of questions about our fuel systems, which we manufacture under the brand Arcane Performance Products. We pretty much think that this is the best bang for buck fuel system on the market. And there's a few different reasons for that. It starts just over a grand. Now, the Stage 1 kit, which is right around 1100 bucks, easily the most affordable drop-in fuel system on the market. Now, what makes it different is that we use two Walbro pumps. Two 274s are standard. You can get it with 285s if you want to. This drops in as an assembly. We use the Radium hat, which I'm going to come back to in a minute. Now, this will drop right into your Mustang fuel tank and hook up to your stock feed line. Now, all you have to do is use a wiring harness to power the pumps externally, like any return fuel system. What makes it a little bit different is the fact that it has a built-in regulator on the hat. Now, this basically makes it so you can set it standard, or you can run vacuum to it. It's a little bit more work to run vacuum back to the hat, but it is less work than running new fuel lines. Now, this gives you a stock feed line return style fuel system with two 274 pumps. Now, at that point, the only restriction is your feed line size. So, that will support, depending on your exact setup, altitude, type of boost, and all that, well over, 800 at the tire. Your restriction at that point is going to be your rails. Now, the next step up, and I'll come back to the hat and why we like this hat, is the Stage 2 kit. Now, what this does is it adds a 8AN feed line as well as our giant filter, stainless filter, serviceable, easy to replace, easy to clean. Now, that's going to go in line. We give a special adapter fitting here with a gauge on it that's going to hook up to your stock fuel rails. So this is a deadhead return system, but all you have to do is run a feed line. Easy to adjust, easy to set up, no problem whatsoever. Now, if you do not want to run the feed line, you get this adapter here, which connects stock feed line, rails, goes in line, nice, quick, easy install with a gauge port so that you can set your pressure. This is our wiring harness. This comes standard with all of our kits. This is made for us by Gin Tuning in Texas. It uses a micro relay box, really nice, small, weather-tight relay box instead of kind of just your generic giant Chinese relays that you'll see in a lot of basic wiring harnesses. We've got a plug-and-play connector for all 11 and up Mustangs. This will make it so it will trigger just like stock, so it primes two inline fuses. We have it set up so that it basically will pass through the firewall to go to your battery junction box, and the fuses will be just inside, so they're kept out of the weather, but they're right by the BCM, so that they're easy to access if you ever have an issue. Another complaint that we have a lot with other fuel systems is the lack of instructions. So with every fuel system from us, you get this nice QR code, or you can just go to the website. There's full diagrams for every level of kit, as well as a kind of basic wiring diagram as far as what you should put where, as well as some helpful tips for where to ground, where to run your wires, etc. Now, if you wish to go to the next level, and the Stage 2 kit with the 8AN feed, we've run that to 1,000 horsepower at the tire. But again, we haven't actually found the limit of this built-in regulator, which again, I'll give you a little bit more information on shortly. But some people still like to run a conventional external regulator. So our Stage 3 kit uses this hat, a block off plate on the regulator and puts the regulator under the hood. More like a conventional setup, still uses our stuff.
So what we have here is a completed stage 3 kit that is ready to go out the door. So as you can see, we have our nice billet rails made for us by our friends at Billet Pro Shop. We have our low profile Y block here, which is straight in, straight out, not off in separate angles. We've got a 4 low pro 180 where it's needed. This particular kit is PTFE. So the fittings look a little bit different than a normal braided end. This is everything as it ships for the most part. We've got our full instructions that come with every kit and show the layout. And this is a completed hat, again, that has the pumps already installed in it. This one is set up for the stage 3 external regulator, so the regulator on the hat is blocked off with these nice low profile banjo swivel fittings. They make everything to install much easier. Lots of room. So this is what our complete kit looks like. It's nice and blacked out. Obviously there's no hoses here, but these are the hard parts.
The nice thing is that it's fully upgradable. So if you get a stage 1 or stage 2 kit right now, you're not doing twice as much work. You're not buying twice as many things. All you have to do if you really want to go to the next level, you know, 11, 1200 at the tire, is you buy an upgrade kit from us, which comes with your return line, your external regulator. We also offer billet rail options to run in parallel, really anything you want to do. And we have a lot of nice features in our full kits too, that we like to differentiate from some of our competition. For example, we have a low profile Y block. This is where we split. Usually we put it in the driver's wheel well. It'll go the single 8N into dual 8AN out into the rails. The fact that it's nice and small and straight, there's no funky angles. Almost all of them have a Y angle. It's nice, clean setup. We also sell those on their own if anybody wants to throw them in their own kit or a different kit. They are on the website as well. Now, that pretty much brings us to the radium hat. And this is something that I want to talk about on its own, because you don't have to buy our full kit to get this. However, our stage 1 kit is pretty basic kit that essentially combines this hat with the pumps and the wiring from us, so that you have everything you need to drop it in. Now, there's a number of reasons we love this hat. We've been using radium hats for a long time because of the bucket. As you can see here, there is a bucket on the hat, and the reason for that is that it holds fuel even when it's sloshing or when it gets low. So most hats, triple pump, they do not have for this setup, because triple pumps will likely run the bucket dry. Twin pumps will support a lot of power, obviously, but the bucket keeps fuel around the pumps. So you do not have the issue of getting down to a half a tank and starving your fuel pumps. Now, it's a common problem with an open hat. You really need to keep it, you know, half a tank or above. This keeps fuel at the pumps so that they're not having an issue. You don't have to keep it at half a tank. It still maintains the factory suction line from the other side, like most hats. It just keeps that bucket. It's the only one on the market that has a nice metal bucket like that. There are, like DW makes one that reuses the factory bucket, but that gets a little bit finicky. Restriction as far as fuel entering the hat. This one, we've never had any issues with. We haven't actually found the limits of the hat yet. People are just happy with, you know, where it ends up. The Venturi and everything is built into it. And like I said, the regulator is built onto the hat as well. So I actually have an assembly going on right here. So I figured I would show you a little bit more about the internals of this hat while it's apart and not just assembled images. So here there's a bucket. This is the bucket. This is the siphon tube, which connects back up to the manifold, which you see here. So this is what's involved in assembling the hat. Basically, this is the top of the hat. This one's already set up for a block off because it's getting a stage 3 external regulator. As you can see, it's got these radium banjo fittings, which are really low profile, easy to swivel to wherever you need them to be during your install. Very nice setup. Now, this is the regulator that comes with it. You remove it for the block off plate that's built right into the hat. You just pop that off, put in the block off plug and O-ring, and seal it up with the plate. Now, this is the manifold setup. This mounts right here. You do have to take that off to put the second pump connection over on the side, which I didn't do yet. And then this is the return and the siphon setup, which bolts right to that. Now, the pumps actually will go from, like you saw in the other image, they kind of mount right about here on this bracket. And then you bolt everything back together, you put the hat back on, and you're ready to drop it in the car. So, stage 1 and stage 2 run wiring and or a feed line only, and it returns right back into the hat just as if the regulator were under hood. It comes with the quick connect fitting for a stock feed line for both 11 to 14 and 15 and up. If you do the stage 1 kit with just the wiring, that is what you will use to hook right into your factory feed, drop it in and go. If you do the stage 2 kit from us, you will get your upgraded feed line and filter and the other fittings here, as well as a feed fitting that replaces this one. And like I said, if you want to do an external regulator conventional return style kit, no problem whatsoever. You take this off, you put the block off plate on, which we include obviously, and then you run your return line into that plugged port. Radium gives you everything you need to assemble it. There's a few different hats depending on the pumps you're using. For our purposes, we only have the one. But it's a really nice, clean setup. Everything is top-notch. The wiring is top-notch. They give you everything. You can either have us assemble it in advance before it comes out to you if you're a little bit intimidated by it. But I will show you the things that you need to do to assemble it. It's not hard at all. You remove a few bolts, you take the hat off, the bucket off, you put the hoses on, you clamp your pumps in, everything is lined up so that you get the height right. You can't mess up the height as long as you follow the directions. And then you put the bucket back on, you drop it in your tank, and you go. Has provisions for stock sender, everything ready to go, ready to drop in the car. You can get it with a section of vacuum hose if you're going to run the on-car, built-in regulator. Or you can set it to static pressure if you want. Discuss that with your tuner. So this is a kind of basic overview of the Arcane fuel systems that we have. We provide all the fittings. We provide routing instructions. A lot of times we will pre-assemble like the fitting sections for the filter so that it's nice and easy for you. You're not having to reference a lot of back and forth. We offer a check valve to add in front of the fuel filter if you need to worry about keeping fuel at the rails. Our harnesses, like I said, it's all marine grade GXL wire, plug and play, micro relay, boxes, and it's all really nice stuff. We're very proud of our fuel systems and the fact that we've managed to keep them cheaper than most of the competition with providing more capability. So we are very proud of them. Check us out. check them out online. The bucket is a huge benefit. It's my favorite part about the whole system in this hat. And I think our biggest seller is probably the Stage 2 kit using the built-in regulator. If you have any questions whatsoever about fuel systems, if you want to upgrade your existing kit, even if it's a different brand, we're happy to discuss with you. $1,100 for a Stage 1 kit is not a huge reach over like a booster pump. You know, you spend $400 on a booster pump, or you spend $1,100 on something that gives you E85 capability and twin Walbro pumps out of the box. That's all we've got for you today. Thanks for watching JP Tech Talk. As always, reach out to us or any member of the team if you've got any technical questions, comment on the videos, reach out on Facebook. We're happy to help get you set up with any of this stuff we're talking about, or just provide tech advice. Also, feel free to reach out if there's anything that you want to see us discuss on a future short or full-length episode. Thanks.